We have two variants of Batman and Trojan horse, A and B. It will delete some of the files, and I made a backup of them, so you can see in here. That will they will delete AUTOEXEC.BAT, CONFIG.SYS, then in Windows folder, protocol, system, and WIN.INI. For variant B, it will also delete HIMEM.SYS, IO.SYS, and MSDOS.SYS. We know that those won't be deleted because they are hidden in system files, as far as I'm guessing. Also, variant B will delete any other file in C drive, program files, then in Windows and system folder, not the Windows folder itself. So only the system folder, only it will try to delete files in there, but it actually fails in there too. So try to consider that's not the case in this case. Along with that, we'll try to run this thing. Let me just set this up. I'll disable the range so you can see that the actual files are being deleted. So take note that this variant will try to delete files from program files, system, and C drive, but not anything in their subfolders. Okay, so let me run it. So we get Batman owes you, Batman owns your sorry ass, haha, where the bat, he just ruined your gay computer. And then after 10 seconds, we get a system crash. So if I try to control alt delete, then again, I get this kind of odd state where I'm guessing that graphics from Windows is displayed in text mode. But for now, I'm just guessing nothing else. So if I try to continue, we get the typical bullscreen of that when system hangs. So I'll just keep going. And I might be able to restart. Okay. So now we are at startup menu. I've put it to boot for 30 seconds, so they don't have to bother with pressing the F8 or delete key at startup. So if I try to boot it normally, you'll see that HIMEM.SYS is missing and that Windows has stopped. So I have to restart again and then try using safe mode. Now I've made a backup. And I'll try to restore the stuff. Okay, so it won't boot from here still. So I have to restart again. And now I should be able to boot normally. Okay, now we could see variant A in this case, right? Well, it's pretty much the same. It just starts the system crash immediately and deletes the files that I've actually mentioned. So we'll skip that for now. Instead, we'll try to run decompile. So this is Visual Basic decompile because these are Visual Basic binaries. So as it just dropped in. We'll also make a decompiled project. Let me just make a folder for it. And for another one. Okay, for B. Okay, now we can see the actual forms for variant A. So we can here we have the Batman form. Kill him, boot him, and add it to the host. But if I try to see the code, there's nothing related to these commands. basically I've just made one, so I'll delete that. So basically on when it runs, it will delete the actual files that I mentioned: AUTOEXEC, CONFIG.SYS, PROTOCOL.INI, WIN.INI, SYSTEM.INI, and then it will run the crash method in this case. Some say that it will actually display a blue screen of death, but I've just got the actual black screen of that. Okay, so there's also a second form that's never displayed, same as this. And it all and has other secret functions. More or less, it just starts few more commands. Well, actually, it starts a command specifically for the thing you actually want. So each of them have a specific command to run with. I'm not sure if I am even able to display the code from here. No, wait. Okay, so this is for the system crash. And that's going to be the same command as before. So it also displays the dialog window before that for safety reasons. And then it runs the same thing. I'm not sure if this is actually a template or something, because I think I've seen this before. I'm not sure about that, but never mind about that. Okay, now for the second variant B. So here we see the actual message that was displayed, and it also has a timer that takes 10 seconds. So now let me show the code. So for the timer, it will crash the system. Then on startup of the form, it will delete AUTOEXEC, CONFIG.SYS, PROTOCOL.INI, WIN.INI, SYSTEM.INI, MSDOS.SYS, IO.SYS, HIMEM.SYS, and then it will also try to delete files from C drive, program files, and system folder. So pretty much the things I've said. All of those deletions are done with kill command. That's from Visual Basic itself, I think. And if you also try to close the form, by some chance, it will also cause the crash. So that's pretty much about those two variants. I'll also show you the details. If I can even see it. Okay, so variant A and B. First one is Batman with product name don't run me. And the second one is Batman.exe with product name Batman with company cheese incorporated. Okay, after we've done all of this, let's try to run Batman.a so I can show you that this is pretty much the same as B, just 10 seconds faster and with minor difference on boot up. Okay, so crash, controller delete as many times as possible. And let's try booting. Okay, cannot find system.ini, you need to run Windows set again. And if I try to continue, it will shut down. That's it. Bye.